quiet boulevard at night, apart from the waves.
Two young political activists, Murat Gesinli and Amin Huseynov, are on a mission. In Azerbaijan, what they are planning to do could lead to treason charges and land them in jail for life.
The plan is that we're going to hit key areas in central Baku with orange-colored political graffiti, the message, freedom and resign. I trust Amin. And I know that Amin means well, that he wants to get these things done. If you don't trust anyone, how can you achieve anything?
What's up? Everything okay? How is the birthday party? All right.
Our mobile groups are in position. What should I be worried about? People have taken risks far higher, far greater than this, in pursuit of liberty and freedom.
But the stakes couldn't be higher. Azerbaijan is a state in which 15,000 well-paid interior ministry troops, loyal to the government, are regularly ordered to stop political dissent. Azerbaijan is 2 months away from a general election. Observers say none of the elections held in the last 12 years have met international democratic standards. Murat and Amin fear the coming elections will not be free and fair either. They believe over half the population wants democratic change, and this action is the first step in a campaign for a peaceful revolution. It was the late president Heydar Aliyev who brought stability to Azerbaijan following the chaotic collapse of the Soviet Union, but at a cost. The US State Department says Azerbaijan's security forces are notorious for committing human rights abuses. The Council of Europe condemns Azerbaijan for torturing political prisoners. When Heydar Aliyev died 2 years ago, his son Ilham kept the political dynasty going by winning a flawed and internationally condemned election in October 2003. But still, the president is not without his supporters.
Not everyone likes our democracy. But Ilham is the son of Heydar Aliyev, and he knows what's best for the people. Period. So.
Our country has great oil resources, and it's not just oil. God gave us everything. It's just that President Aliyev has stripped us of our freedom.
Azerbaijan is perched on the Caspian Sea and sandwiched between Iran and Russia. A moderate Muslim state, oil-rich, expecting $160 billion in revenue in the next 2 decades. British Petroleum leads an international consortium here that is upgrading the oil infrastructure and investing $22 billion. But Azerbaijan has a reputation from international observer groups for corruption. Many worry that the oil revenue will disappear into the pockets of the elite. 40% of the population lives in poverty. When President Ilham Aliyev came to power, Amin was covering the elections as a journalist for a local news agency. Widespread vote rigging triggered clashes in the capital, Baku, between the police and opposition supporters. More than 700 people were arrested, 300 injured, and one protester died. Emin himself was badly beaten and ended up in hospital. It's this experience that led him to form the pro-democracy youth movement called Magum. It's time.
The very fact that me and countless others were beaten and even killed on 16th of October 2003 made many to understand that the present regime has no right to rule Azerbaijan, and that sooner or later this regime will be forced to go. As for my dad, he jokingly says that I was not sufficiently beaten back in 2003, and that only more beatings will make me smarter. Then again, they think that what I'm doing is childish and can end very badly.
But recent events in the region have given the protesters hope that it doesn't have to end badly.